I got the diamonds around my neck.
Turn my
and
mic
the
up a little bit. All right, turn the music down. Can you guys hear me on YouTube? Let me know. The lighting's super dark in here. I probably should have picked a better spot, but it's top-down lighting, so I look like Neo from The Matrix over here. Or Blade, one of them. So yes, we're going to be live with Hood Beats today. We're going to go over how to level up as a music producer. So we're going to be live in 2 seconds. Let me let him know. I'm on now. Give me 1 second, y'all. Letting him know we're good to rock. So I see V-Nize is here. We got Kai to Society. We got Gray Haze Radio. Forgive me, y'all. I'm in the back room of the studio because we're getting help from Nate. Shout out to Nate helping me configure the studio right now. Shout out to Ron D. Silvestro, one of my mentors, helping me out today. But yes, that's why I'm in the back boiler room right now, going live. So it's not the greatest lighting, but it is what it is. My camera keeps doing something crazy. I'm trying to have it, whatever, it's all good. I'm in a different chair, everything's different. Tilt Mob is here, welcome, welcome. Eric Music is here, we got Raphael. Oya K-Bid is here, we got Talola is here, we got Caleb Hamilton is here, welcome. All right, so as long as the audio's good, we should be good to rock. Let me let Hood Beats in so he could be the big screen. And that way we don't have to look at my little tiny web camera. Let's get a meeting. Let's kick this up. He's probably like, where is this guy at? All right, my bad. I had to switch the headsets and everything. So my whole setup is different. Gunslingers here. We got Jokestar. Let me make sure my camera's on. We got Two Master. Welcome, welcome. We're about to get into it. How to level up as a music producer is a mindset thing. Let me turn this off so that this can use my other camera. And bam. At least you can see me kind of better on the big screen. Not really, but it's a little bit better. This is the greatest background thing to have in your background. This is two people. I'm gonna go with Hood Beats. Right, we're gonna let him in. See what's going on. Yo, man. Hello?
Yeah. Oh, bro.
Yo, can you hear me?
There.
Awesome. Let me turn this music off. Sorry, my.
Ain't even that loud.
Music is blasting in my ears. In my ears, it is. Did you have another account that hopped into?
What?
I can't really hear you on your side.
Can't hear me?
I can, but wait, say something now.
Yo, yo.
Okay, you're good. It's just like a noise cancellation thing. Did you have a webcam at all, or was the...
Yeah, man, this shit broke, bro. That shit look crazy, don't it? It look crazy?
It's all good, because even on my end, I got... No, I don't, but... Oh, now I do it. There you go. There you go. I just wanted to make you big screen because my lighting is not the greatest right now.
Sure.
Awesome. Awesome. How you feeling, man?
Good. Good.
Oh, I can't really hear you. Darn, I don't know if it's a connection. Yeah, I don't know if it's a connection thing or if it's the something else, like a noise cancellation. That's my guess.
You hear me now?
There he is. Yeah, I hear you loud and clear. Darn, I heard you for a second. Now it's back to...
You hear me now?
He's like, every time you say, can you hear me now? I can hear you. And then
you have to straight up, like, have to talk.
Darn, it's choppy. Let me see if the chat can hear you. Can you guys hear him clearly? Yeah, it's kind of like, can you hear me now? It's like that.
Right.
Yeah, the only thing I could think of is like a noise cancellation plugin or something.
Yeah, let me check.
Yeah, he got the vocal chain going.
You funny.
You got the crystal clear audio. No, thank you for being so patient. If you could hear me. I just want
to
say.
What about now? Does that have anything to do with it? Anything to do with it?
It's still better. Maybe because I'm speaking so much. I'm going to let you speak, and then I want to see if it goes steady. Dang, nah, it's still choppy.
Yeah,
might have to hop back in or something. But in the meantime, I could hold the show till you hop back in.
Yeah, let me do that.
Okay.
Right back. All right.
There it is. Cool. I don't even know how to. Okay, cool. So let me say my hellos real quick. We got Eric is here. We got Rafael. We got Puya. We got Talola. Caleb is here. Gunslinger says, what up? What up? Again, forgive me. I'm in the boiler room of the studio, so the lighting is like extra dark back here. What else? Who else is up in here? Jokestar, Two Masters here. Says the game. One Yo Beats says, yo, Busy, how's it going? It's going well. Getting the studio reconfigured. Thanks to Nate. Thanks to one of my mentors, Ron D. Silvestro. So I appreciate you. So I'm letting him do his thing over there. He's helping me out. Left Jab says, what's up? Shadow Tink is here. Teddy Dat Era says, what's good? Everything's good. V-Nize is here. I just got to get close to the camera. Y'all just going to get real intimately close to my face. V-Nize is here. Busy in the back rooms. Exactly. You could tell by this. This is unkempt wiring that's right here on the wall. Who else is up in this piece? We got Venenzo is here. Sup, bro? Always bring that value. Thank you. Yeah, we're going to get you into because Hood Beats produced for Future, Waka Flocka. I'm going to pull them in again. Let's see if this fixes anything. Switch back. Hold up. And who else is up in here? Two Master Gunslinger says, don't back into that wire. You got electrocuted. Yeah. Yes.
Am I clearer now?
So far.
Yeah, shouldn't be, bro. Shouldn't be, but.
Darn, man, it's chopping up again. It might be a connection thing.
Are you using your phone?
No, I'm on the computer. The Wi-Fi?
Yeah, me too. Bro. Run a business.
Dang, I don't know. Yeah, now it's like I hear you. Like, I'm going to let you speak. And then if it gets really, really off, then we'll figure it out.
Yeah, I don't know why it's low like that. Crazy.
I don't know if this might, maybe it's canceling out. Hold on, let me double check.
Yeah, ask the chat.
But we hear you so far. Oh, you said ask the chat. I just heard what you said just 2 seconds ago.
What about now? Did that change anything?
I'm gonna let you go. I'm not gonna interrupt.
Just testing. Yeah, it said my microphone good.
They said it's good. People think it's the noise suppression. But I don't know what that could be. I don't know if it's baking.
I don't know why I'm looking at it. Damn, my system is great.
Darn, man.
Switch the phone audio, leave computer audio settings.
Oh, man. We could.
What about, is it better now? I think I just got to talk loud.
Maybe so. They're saying
suppression, suppressed background noise. Low.
Oh, is that Zoom? Yeah, that's Zoom doing that.
Yeah.
My fault. Yeah, that's what it is. Yeah. So I have mine on auto. Suppressed background noise.
Put it on auto.
That's what I have mine on.
Okay.
But if it's still.
What about now?
The crystal clear.
I hope so, bro. It's like, I see what you're talking about, though. I see what you're talking about.
Yes, exactly.
So I'm just going to have to talk to you a little bit louder, though. That's all.
Zoom is, they were trying to hold you back, hold the secrets back.
Yeah, man.
So, yeah, loud and clear. Welcome.
I can't see the chat.
Oh, this is on YouTube. I have the YouTube channel on one side, and then Zoom is on a whole different thing.
Okay.
Gotcha. How you feel? Forgive all the chaos today. Goodness, but
My bad, though.
No, it's all good. It's all good.
Definitely. Yeah, YouTube channel.
Awesome. How you feeling, man?
Yeah, I'm doing good, man. I'm blessed. Can't complain, bro. Career on the uprise. Even more, you know what I'm saying? Hey, connections are solid. I have no reason to complain, bro. Like, complaining wouldn't get me nowhere. I mean, a lot of people would take my life and not complain at all, so I'm not going to complain at all, bro.
Awesome. You know what I'm saying?
For sure.
Love the positive attitude. What have you been, I titled this, How Music Producers Can Level Up. So it's like a mindset thing.
Mm-hmm.
So even you starting off with looking at the positives as opposed to looking at what's wrong.
Mm-hmm.
Like, let's break into that just right off the rip. Just how do you get into that state where you can stop focusing on everything that's negative?
Okay. Okay, I'm gonna tell you. Things are gonna be negative. Even when you get big placements, you know what I'm saying? You look at the track record, it gets a little funner, but it still gets harder. You get what I'm saying? Things are not gonna go your way. You know what I'm saying? I learned that big time. You know what I'm saying? You gotta have patience because you really don't know. If you're not there in the room, a lot of things that happen behind your back is what take you out of there. You get what I'm saying? So while you're getting down and out, destroyed, and think it's all over, because it's been times where it's like every time I think, you know what I'm saying? Excuse me, you know what I'm saying? But, and that day it happened, something amazing happened. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, it's not over until you give up. You know what I'm saying? I got a lot of positive, you know, energy around me. You know what I'm saying? Management, brothers, you know what I'm saying? The support system for my city, Greenville. So it's like, but if you don't have that, you know what I'm saying? Because one time, I'm gonna be honest, I didn't have it, you know what I'm saying, to the crowd. So if you don't have that, you're gonna really have to know that you can press yourself and do it. You know what I'm saying? Reach out to producers and stuff like that. But just don't give up, bro. Cause it's the biggest producers in the world, we go through stuff. You know what I'm saying? Like, don't think that nobody go through anything. You know what I'm saying? Y'all see our lives, y'all see everything that's going on like that. But you gotta know that we go through things too. Things get slow sometimes, and sometimes they just bubble. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, to get through it is to go through it. And if you're going through it right now, I promise you're going to get through it. You get what I'm saying?
Right. Yeah. Like, I learned.
To get through it. Yeah. Like, go ahead.
No. I learned. Yeah, I realized. Were you sharing the Zoom link? Because I could let people in. I didn't realize I thought that was like another computer.
Yeah, I was sharing the Zoom link.
Oh, gotcha.
Okay. I shared it my management, I shared it. I was on the phone with one of my bros, Grammy nominated Fritz, you know what I'm saying? He on call, he was gonna hop in. Mayhem, Futures Engineer, like, you know, I had some people that were gonna come.
My fault, I didn't know who Michael was. I thought that was like your other account or something, trying to log in. Nah. My fault. Sorry, Michael, I didn't mean to.
Oh no, that's my management. That's one of my brothers. When I did the record with Future, he changed me, he helped me, he helped guide me.
Dope.
He put me in the right rooms. He introduced me to ATL Jacob. You know what I'm saying? Like, put me on the phone with great guys. You know what I'm saying? So, end of the day, I love my brother. He helps me out a lot. When I did that song, he changed my life. Studio that I'm opening, right beside next door to ABS. You know what I'm saying? All of that. So you just looking
great. Awesome. It's a little choppy again. Sorry, I didn't mean to. You were on a run. Okay. No, it's all good.
Bad,
it's Zoom. It's not you. It's Zoom. They're hating on us right now.
Yeah.
So, like you said, those introductions, being in the studio, but it's also the stuff that goes behind the scenes that a lot of folks don't understand game that's happening.
Mm-hmm. You think it's not happening because it's not happening in front of you. But see, I did songs still to this day that I got on my computer with artists. Like long way and shit, like just stuff that I can't even put out. Like, you know what I'm saying? Dirt new artists, you know what I'm saying? Shout out my brother Thule for doing that. Like, it's a lot of stuff, you know what I'm saying, that I can't really even put out. And it might come out, it might not come out. I listen to it, my brothers, whoever around me might listen to it, but I can't do nothing with it. So bro, you can never get discouraged with what's going on behind your back, you know what I'm saying? Because I didn't know none of that stuff. And a lot of the songs that do come out, they come out in 3 days. I don't even know. You feel me? Like, it's boom, 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 boom. The songs that I hear and I know about that I don't really know. And 9 times out of 10, I don't know that it's going on. I'm just going to be honest, bro. And I got a lot of placements. I was they was just getting pulled up. You know what I'm saying?
Right. And basically what I'm hearing you say to let everybody else know is that when you're doing all this work, here's Michael, my fault. I didn't mean to have him confused. Is basically when you're putting in all this work, you never know the release dates. One, because they don't want people to leak information. Two, because they don't even know if they're going to leave it on the album or not, or the project or not. And then three is people just move so fast. You know, it's a chess game. Like if they realize, that's why a lot of artists drop out of nowhere, because they want to surprise the enemy. So if they're reacting to somebody else dropping, like if Nicki Minaj drops and then you had a record that was supposed to come out that Friday, they're not going to drop that Friday. They're going to move it to a different Friday. So that's why people don't give dates and all this type of stuff for the most part.
You get disappointed, man, but hey, you can't stop, bro. And I can tell you this, if you're a producer and you're just trying to get in it just real, real quick for the money, it's very, very hard. You got to love it.
Right.
You got to love it.
Right. And what are some things to understand on how to endure and spread out the energy that it takes to create that sustainability, so to speak, just to spread it out? People don't realize, like, they really got to spread it out. They think it's this, you know, they get something every single day. It's just not like that. For the beginners, I mean, even on the top level, it's just not stuff every single day.
Oh, yeah, man. Hold on. When you say spread it out, like, spread what out?
Energy, motivation, effort.
Oh, yeah, man. Yeah, bro. Like, I'm going to tell you this. You're going to probably more than likely, if you're sad every day, let's say you go out, right? And you network with a whole bunch of people and you're sad every day. When they look on your Instagram and they see that sad stuff all day, every day, you think they want to see that? No. You know what I'm saying? Like, even if they could be going through something, like, people don't want to see, you know what I'm saying, the sad, the negativity all day, every day. And once I learned that I'm going to have to get through this anyway. You know what I'm saying? Like, oh, I'm going to have to do this with my wife. You know what I'm saying? I know it. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, bro, like, once you come to that level, bro, then you'll be. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's the only way I can. I don't really know. And then, like, to endure, like, anybody who come my way, bro, I don't have no negative, like I said, bro, like, you won't know, you will never know, like, and that's what put me in, I say, a lot of great positions, too. It's my positive energy, bro, like, I don't got no reason to be, like, no reason, like, even if I have reasons that will make up for that, you know what I'm saying, like,
right,
and, like, that's how I can put it, bro, like, the positive. That's the only thing that's gonna work. Nobody don't want to see sadness all day, every day.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it's ride wave is rare.
He's a
you
rare.
You know what I'm saying? He's ride wave is rare. You know what I'm saying? Like it. Like you sad shit, man. If you're not grabbed from a label, something doing that, then you need to leave it alone and live your life, man. You know what I'm saying? Because every time I'm going through something sad, I always run into somebody who's going through. The most sad. Every time I think I'm having trouble financially, I run into somebody who got some the most going on. You feel me?
Right.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Could like $200,000 studio type stuff. You know what I'm saying? Downtown Atlanta type stuff. Like,
oh wow.
That's so. At the end of the day, we all got to be positive. You know what I'm saying? Because personally, I work with any producer. I work with producers in my city. I don't discriminate. I ain't a big head. Anybody can Google me or whatever. You know what I'm saying? They can look at everything that I've done. All the artists. I work with anybody off their energy. You know what I'm saying? If it's genuine, that's cool. You get what I'm saying? But right. if you just sad, you begging, you want a handout or whatever, that's not, give me a reason to want to work. Be happy. You know what I'm saying? Drop some 5 beats. You know what I'm saying? Something like that. Send me, I don't know, bro. Send some loops. I don't know.
Yeah.
But yeah, like, but to post sad stuff for your life story every day. Now we get on Instagram to see positivity. I do anyways. You know what I'm saying? Even if it's some negative stuff, it's still like, it's not nobody real.
Right.
You get what I'm saying?
Right. I think
just to be out of it.
Yeah. I think
nobody ain't winning. Like, your friends care. You know what I'm saying? The ones who love you, know who love you and know who you. That's another thing. you got people in your life where you can discuss that with. So don't push them to the side. Discuss it with them, because these people who you think they want to, that you think want to discuss, you know what I'm saying? They don't. You know what I'm saying? That's just honest, man. Don't push your people to the side that who really.
Yeah, you're kind of going in and out again. We're piecing it together, though, but...
Yeah, I said, don't put your people to the side who really, really are there for you. Forget about them to deal with people who you unsure about. You know what right. I'm saying? Because that shit is painful when it's the unsure is positive. I mean, is you right. You know what I'm saying? But you done shunned everything that's really behind you. So pay attention to what's really behind you. Discuss your negativity or with the people who you know gonna feel that, you know what I'm saying? Later on in life, you know, you could be friends with close friends, brothers with the biggest producer in the world. And that's what that's the type of things y'all discuss. But there's a time for everything. That's all. There's a time for everything. And I say negativity, it's 3%.
You said, oh, the last piece dipped out. You said
negativity. It's about 3%.
3%. Right. Yeah. You know what I'm little like, toxicity. No, this is like,
don't even. Yeah, bro. Yeah, don't even do it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I agree with that, because one thing I had to learn is I used to project whatever I was feeling into IG stories, for example, and like content and different things. This is years ago. And I realized it was hurting people around me. I don't think people understand. Like, we got to keep business. The one thing to help me level up is to not express my thoughts on social media. That sounds so counterintuitive, but really just keeping it to myself. You know, a lot of people try to like find a meme and bash somebody else. It's like anything, like you're saying, Hood Beats, is that anything that's a negative or hurting somebody else or bashing somebody else? It's just, what's the point? Who gains out of that? Yeah, and you talked about too, just the cycles, understanding how to stretch out a lifestyle. Like, a lot of people have to be more open than what they expect. So how do you collab with, like, what is your thing? If you don't know somebody, how do you get them to want to work with you? Does that make sense?
Yeah, it do. I can tell you how what the things people could do to make you want to work with them. But me personally, I didn't work on the beats with nobody. You get what I'm saying? I just became friends with an engineer. You get what I'm saying?
Right.
So it was like, then it was, that's how that happened. But when I say, as far as networking, a lot of people like positive. I didn't know that. I didn't. That's where I lacked. Get what I'm saying? Network. If I had a network, I'd be a gazillionaire by now. I didn't even know. Like, I was that. That's another problem. A lot of producers get stuck. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm stuck. I'm only 2 hours away from Atlanta, it was a long time before I realized that 24 hours in a day, bro, that's something that you need. Huh? Get what I'm saying?
Right.
So, yeah, bro. Like, once you get past the fact that the internet. Like, this is one thing my management told me, you know what I'm saying? The internet is something that it works, but it don't work like that. It works, but like, if you're not dealing with somebody very, very beginning, before they was nothing and then they blow up, because that happened a lot with me. Like, a lot of the guys who I was dealing with, we was getting placements with the same people, but them people wasn't, they were still like growing. Stuff, you know what I'm saying? And then boom, you know what I'm saying? So we interacted at our times as low level producers. You get what I'm saying? So I say, like, if I had known to move around, it would have worked a lot. So move around if you're a producer, come out and touch people's hands. Because me personally, if I meet somebody, I work with them. You get what I'm saying? Like, mm-hmm. It's like, if you're coming around, it's like, oh, let me check you out. You know what I'm saying? So don't think it's not possible. Maybe just you can't do it from where you at. So you need to move around. You come out, you see somebody, for instance, if you see somebody in the club every single night, you know what I'm saying? Go in there and have a shot or something. You know what I'm saying? Don't be no groupie. Don't be no groupie. There is a difference, you feel me? But if your intentions is pure, it's gonna work. You get what I'm saying? If it don't work, just keep it moving, but don't stop right there. So right. It's 1,000 producers that got $1 million that we probably don't even, like, it's a lot going on that we don't know. When you look at the Grammy credits, it's a lot of people, right?
Right.
When you look at movie credits, it's a lot of people, right? Not just the director or the people we know about. It's a whole team of people that we don't know about. So basically, get out of network and don't think you're not going to meet you're not gonna meet somebody, like, I ain't gonna just put no name out there, but you're not gonna meet the person that's behind the scenes really putting the work in, like, on the computer, because you don't know who he is.
Right.
But if you out there and you in the right places, mingling, and you specifically doing your music thing, it's gonna work out for you. You get what I'm saying? Tell them that's what you got going on, and it mean a lot for real when you coming from far away to force your dreams, man.
Right, you said 2 hours away. That's a whole different state.
That ain't long. It's people who drive longer. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But it don't go unnoticed when you're doing it. And you got everybody know everybody living real life. So if you're an up-and-coming producer, you're getting on the ball and you're going to handle your business, your beat spot, you're going to go up. You will run into somebody.
Right. I do believe. Sorry, there's a little delay. I do believe that the cream rises to the top. And what I think, too, is that a lot of people underestimate the folks behind the scenes. Like you said, Michael was here. That's your manager?
Yeah.
But, like, I'm just saying Michael because he's on your team, for example.
Yeah, for sure.
Because people don't realize the people who support them until they're gone. Like, they're like, oh, yeah, they think they're the god of everything. Like Future even said on his new album, he's like, I'm a god on this earth or something like that. But yeah. What happens if Future's whole system just collapses? Like, all the people who push Future. Like, he's the face of something.
Right.
He needs all those people to be Future. I'm not bashing Future. I'm saying
no man can do it by himself. Everybody needs somebody, bro. You'll be surprised. Everybody got somebody. Everybody. Because you would think NBA Youngboy do it by himself. But I mean the people say that he dropped music and he's not supposed to. So if he wasn't supposed to, then you know what I'm saying? He got a team, basically. He got somebody telling him. Everybody got somebody behind them, helping them get to where they're going, or, you know what I'm saying, helping them look good, or however you want to put it. Everybody got somebody.
That's a good point. You're like, yeah, if he wasn't supposed to do it, then that means somebody is telling him if he's supposed to or not supposed to. That's deep. That's actually deep.
You get what I'm saying? Yeah. If he wasn't supposed to do it, then that means, what do you mean he's not supposed to? You get what I'm saying?
Well, here's a good question for people trying to level up. I'm trying to get as much lighting as possible. I got to be right here next to the camera to get the. I'm looking along in the shade. What was I gonna say? Oh, when to expand your, like, how did they cross the chasm from being at home on the internet to actually leveling up in the, I'll say, the industry? Did it, like, what was the first person you put around you and your circle?
Really, it was the first person when you say, like, okay, when I did the song with, I want to say I was working with, I did a song with Walker, and then he put El Dorado Red on the song, and then we ended up giving the song to El Dorado Red. You feel me? Boom. But that was this dude named Caveman. You know what I'm saying? He placed a lot of cavemen. He placed a lot of people. He big time. Once, you know what I'm saying? Big time in the PSM.
Sorry, it's choppy a little bit.
And then I started working with a guy named Lil Freaky. You know what I'm saying? And Woo. You know what I'm saying? That's how that came about. Like, I got my placement with them. I came right, and then I did a song with the rest of Sean. Famous, but the rest of Sean and Joe Green, and it hit like 1.2 million. So I was like, okay, I'm all the way in Michigan. I gotta go, you know what I'm saying, down. I didn't really know what I was gonna do. So when I came down, I ended up going to the studio with Lil Freaky. He got songs with Buddha on shit too. But I'm chilling in the studio with him. I ended up kicking it with this engineer, you know what I'm saying, named Fritz. That's how that happened. I was kicking it with him. And he was like, man, I'm keep pulling you up. You know what I'm saying? I don't live here. I just came down from Michigan. As soon as I came to South Carolina, I'm like, okay, today I'm going to Atlanta. Just to see.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? And then the first person I put around to really elevate me, just to be all the way real with you, was, you know what I'm saying, Fritz. He just, you know what I'm saying, he did the whole lot of Red album for Playboi Carti, and he just got nominated for a Grammy, you know, do a whole lot of music. Look him up, Fritz Mix on Instagram. That's my brother. Yeah, but he started bringing me in, you know what I'm saying, and took me around Durkin, Freaky and them, you know what I'm saying, we got to rock, and then I started rocking with Woo. He introduced me into him. I did a song with Future, and everything was like, bro was like, took me right to the Future, you know what I'm saying, so I got the videos, getting signed and all of this, you know what I'm saying, a couple years ago, and they started introducing me into a lot of nice producers, you know what I'm saying, I met ATL Jacob at a big party, you know what I'm saying, everything started, this was years ago, you know what I'm saying, mm-hmm. And then that's when I had the problem of not moving around. Like, I'm just going to be honest, I stopped. I thought I could do it from home because I was elevating so fast. Right. You know what I'm saying? Then I realized there was nothing else that I could do. So I had to. It was like, it didn't get no easier. It got harder. Like, harder. You know what I'm saying? It get funner, but you got to move around. You got to plan. You got to, you know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of producers right now, they wake up, they plan to make beats, send them off. No, you got to plan with your family. You're going to have to go here, go there. You're going to have to go on the road. You're going to have to do all types of stuff. So it get funner, but it don't get easier at all.
No, that's deep. It's kind of like people who want to win the lottery so much and they don't realize money management is a whole skill set that you have to have, or else you're going to lose the money you just made, basically. So people could win I think it was a study done in the UK. Somebody won like $5 million in the lottery, and then they were worse off after 2 years or something like this than what they were before, because they didn't have the management skills. So what you're saying is people want the glam of the industry, but they don't know what it takes to consistently move in that.
You're not going to sleep. You know what I'm saying? You're going to have to put your work in. When you get your sleep, you're going to be thinking like, oh, I should be doing this. So it's going to be a wreck sleep.
Wow, you know what I'm saying? Sleep.
Yeah, like, it's a wreck sleep, bro. Like, every time I'm ready to go to bed, I know I need to drive to Atlanta and get into a studio. Like, so it's hard to sleep, too, because I'm always wanting to work.
Right. You love it.
To be honest.
Yeah, so I want to talk about the effort that it takes, because a lot of people, again, they see the glam of what we do. For example, even on YouTube, they see the glam of Simon Savita or BusyWorks Beats or something like this. They don't understand, like, they have to build a whole business behind it, though. They see just making a YouTube video. They don't understand you got to build a whole business behind it. So what is something you can tell people that is like a lifestyle, kind of like to be a high performer, what do you think are some lifestyle things that are required? Like you said, sleep, for example, you're probably going to get less sleep. Or guaranteed to get less sleep.
Okay. Yeah. You have to be available. You have to be available. And you're going to need to be available at times where you're not going to be available. So you have to be readily available. You have to make You know what I'm saying? Like, I have no plans of doing nothing, you know what I'm saying, but making my music today. But if I definitely get a car, I'm going. You know what I'm saying? Like, and I got children and all. You know what I'm saying, bro? So it's like, you have to make yourself readily available, you know what I'm saying? Your schedule out. You know what I'm saying?
Awesome. Real quick, the audio.
Yeah, it's been times where, you know what I'm saying, I regret the calls I made so bad. You get what I'm saying? Ain't miss them no more. Can't miss those calls no more. So yeah, I say one of the main things is make yourself readily available at all times. And don't stop networking. You know what I'm saying? If you can force it, man. Don't be, move around. You know what I'm saying? Go shake some hands. Don't think that the internet is everything, because it's only a piece of it. You gotta get out and get your face somewhere and try to collab with producers if possible. You know what I'm saying? Another thing, I think producers should, when it comes to like like the way they market themselves. You know what I'm saying? You can market yourself. If you don't got the answer, don't be afraid to ask questions. Don't be afraid to read. You know what I'm saying? Don't be afraid to go back to school and learn yourself. You get what I'm saying? For sure. You know what I'm saying? But as far as marketing, man, don't be no troll. You get what I'm saying? A lot of people think that trolling, you know what I'm saying, begging, you know what I'm saying, being a jerk or whatever, because you gotta know that this might be his guy, this might be his guy, this might be his guy. Like, bro, be yourself on the internet. You know what I'm saying? Be yourself on the internet. Hey man,
just anything, even the stuff that people may underestimate.
Keep all negativity, you know what I'm saying, out the way. For sure, you got to keep the negativity out the way, bro. You got to keep the negativity out the way. And keep your sound the same, be you, you know what I'm saying? But pay attention to what's going on. So, like, pay attention, be you, but pay attention to what's going on in the music. Listen to the radio, turn on the radio. So basically, when you working with a producer, or maybe you got an opportunity, or you sending out beats, you know what I'm saying? Pay attention to what they like. You know what I'm saying? When you send a beat, you know what I'm saying? Don't just send out anything. You know what I'm saying? But be yourself. Pay attention to the sound, and like for real, say, man, mimic the greats, bro. It's in 48 laws of power, but be yourself. You get what I'm saying? So don't overdo it. You know what I'm saying? Like, don't overcrowd your beat. You know what I'm saying? If it don't belong, leave it out. You get what I'm saying? Like,
true. That part.
Yeah, for real, bro. Like, you gotta leave leg room. You gotta leave space for the artists to do their thing. You know what I'm saying? So I say, but for sure, be yourself. Don't try to be so much like him. You can be like you can take little things. Everybody done listen to Zaytoven. Everybody done listen to Drummer Boy. You know what I'm saying? I feel like he get left out a lot. That's my Drummer Boy, you know what I'm saying? Zay. And you know what I'm saying? That's a them, you know what I'm saying? Producers like that. Everybody got producers who they look up to, or they done pick the sound from. Everybody got a snare or a drum on their computer right now that sound like, or that came from an OG like DJ Paul or some Memphis or something like that. You get what I'm saying? Like, everybody got something like that. So to say you're not trying to be like nobody, that's kind of crazy. But you can be yourself, you know what I'm saying? And still throw now drums on. You know what I'm saying? That's basically what I'm getting at. Like, you can do your own sound selection, but type shit. Yeah. Nah, you know what I'm saying? Like, make it make sense. So when you're sending off music, make sure you make it make sense. You know what I'm saying? And,
right.
Make sure you make your music.
That's what I like about the Bay Area. Their sound is based around that wow, 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 that sound.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But the cool part is they can sample like anything and put it on top.
Yeah, so they have, and they do it, and they do it well. You know what I'm saying? And all the producers over there, it's producers over there that's getting, we don't even know. They got some big songs, probably platinum and all off that sound. You know what I'm saying? Got Mustard, and you got a lot of creators over there like Dr. Dre and all that. They can't not be like him. That's what I was saying. Like, so you gotta mimic grace in a way, still be yourself.
Right. It's like, you know, the Chick-fil-A sandwich is probably the number one known chicken sandwich in the world. So they figured out the formula that works. If McDonald's wants to come out with a product that is kind of like it, but not the exact same things, so they don't take their intellectual property, they'll go, okay, what do we start with? We need flour, we need chicken, you know, the butter bun, all that type of stuff. But they cook it in their own way. It's the same type of ingredients, but they cook it in their own way to now people can accept their product. They might not be the Chick-fil-A sandwich, but they can accept it as a great thing because they already figured out the formula. Funny enough, you said mimic the greats, though, because there was a placement opportunity for Cardi B one time. And they told me she wanted, I don't know if this is private information, but whatever. They told me that she wanted, what was it? The Isley Brothers record. She wanted it to feel like an Isley Brothers record. And we had to like put the sample in and then take the sample out. mm-hmm. and like build around the sample, then take the sample out.
Yeah.
You know what exactly I mean? What or using saying. Acapellas can give you that room too. Do you use acapellas?
Nah, I don't use acapellas. Nah, I just make beats, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's all. I don't use no acapellas, but hey, that's lovely too. You get one of those, that'd be fun too.
But you know what I'm saying? Yeah, sorry. How do you know when you're overfilling a beat?
Oh, man. It just won't go. Like, it just won't. Like, basically, I know I'm overfilling the beat when I can't find nothing else to go in. Like, I'm trying to figure out, like, what pattern? What's going? I know I can do something with this sound. I know I can do something with this sound. Oh, this sound hard. I can't figure out the pattern I need. Maybe you might need to give it a break, come back on it tomorrow, and then that works too. Or not put the sound in. You know what I'm saying? Not overcrowd. You know what I'm saying? And another thing, bro, is I feel like a lot of producers, upcoming producers, don't take their loads.
You said, sorry?
They don't take the loads. Like, they don't take their loads out. Oh. So when I get... Like Omnisphere sounds, you know how sometimes they heavy. That's like a movie thing. Like, it's heavy. You know what I'm saying? So take your lows out and mix your beats. You know what I'm saying? Leave headroom for the engineers. You know what I'm saying? That's a big thing. Gotta leave a little bit of headroom and don't have it peaking. So my head start hurting when I listen. You know what I'm saying? Like, oh man, that's crazy. Like, it could be the hardest beat ever. You know what I'm saying? But man, if my head start hurting while I'm listening to it, bro. I'd be like, oh man, like the high is too high. You know what I'm saying? Like, but if you leave headroom, it won't ever peak. That's one thing I learned. You turn your bass all the way up, turn your main down.
It was funny because when you went like this, the audio was perfect. It was like, I don't know if it's because you're directing the audio to the mic. It was perfect. When you hear this back, you'll understand from our perspective. I want to ask you though about Clubhouse, because I've been bringing on a lot of folks who were in the Clubhouse fam and they don't understand the power of even Clubhouse. So you got to break down the secret sauce from what you experienced, at least, on Clubhouse.
Clubhouse is lit, bro. Like, it's really a cheat code. I'm just going to put y'all out. And if you want, yeah, it's a cheat code, man. Like, if you really are who you say you are, you can win on that. Like, for real, like, it gave me a voice to thousands of people. You feel me? It gave, like, I don't get on it as much as I used to, but bro, it's a cheat code. If you find genuine people, man, I met Lil Ronnie on there. He got in the studio. That's like my bro. He got me and him that collabed on songs and stuff. Like, he do K Michelle music. You know what I'm saying? I'm welcome in the studio anytime. Like, that's a connection. You know what I'm saying? You a connection.
Right.
You feel me? I think I might have met you on that. Right. Feel me? Man, who was that?
Wait, I want to break. They need to know who Lil Ronnie is. They need to know who Lil Ronnie is. Lil Ronnie did R. Kelly. Like, he has so many top artists. It's ridiculous. I don't remember his whole thing.
Yeah, almost like a million-dollar studio. He got a $1 million studio downtown. He got plenty of plaques, bro. He's a big guy, man, at Lil Ronnie on YouTube. That's another thing. People don't know about these people. You won't hear his name all over everywhere, but you see the amount of work that he put in. You know what I'm saying? So that's the goal, to show that, you know what I'm saying, you got to get out and you got to network. But yeah, that Clubhouse, bro, that was major. You know what I'm saying? I met Urko, who did Donda. You know what I'm saying? Me and him rock. You know what I'm saying? Like, and it's been time in between, and it's genuine. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're going to meet the people who the rappers like being around for a reason.
Right.
You get what I'm saying?
I got
you know
a shot.
What I'm saying? Like, they like being around them for a reason because of who they are and how they really act in real life. There's the people who chilling in the house or in the house with your favorite rapper right now. You know what I'm saying? Just chilling on Clubhouse. And it's like, yeah, I done met a whole lot of connections on that road. I done made a lot of money off it too.
Right.
You feel me? Like I get on, like, it's beautiful, bro. You get up to your following. You might have potential to make money because people gravitate to you because they like.
True.
So versus putting it in front of a whole bunch of people, and a lot of these people don't even know us nothing about music. stuff, but they might like it. Feel what I'm saying? Versus
true.
You on a whole platform full of people, and you know they gravitate towards you because they like what you do. So that's a real big difference. And you can be in a room with a lot of people, anybody talk. You know what I'm saying? Like, and I done been in rooms with real big artists and artists who used to be big that's not really big no more, and they in there with four people, so you can have a direct conversation with
them. Right.
You know what I'm saying? Not to say no names, like for real, like that. Like, you meeting people's managers, you know what I'm saying? Like, that shit crazy, bro. And then, you know what I'm saying? It was another, yeah, bro, that's about it on Clubhouse thing, bro. It's a tool that could be used great. Like, period, bro. It helped me out a lot. Gave me some great connections. Like, I can't say any life-changing ones now, but boy, they potential. Like,
bigger than
ever. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, like I can tell who came.
Go ahead and take it with me.
Oh, sorry, there's a delay. I can tell who came from Clubhouse based on if you go to the mutuals on Instagram.
Yeah.
I can say, oh, they're from Clubhouse. You know,
yeah,
that's how I can tell.
Bro.
And Irko put me. Irko invited me to Clubhouse, so I owe Irko. You know, there we had so many opportunities come out of Clubhouse. I'm working now with my mentor and business partner Chris Moyer, and we're working on some stuff with like this $7 billion protocol called Near. Who makes like cryptocurrency? They're like the number 18 or something in the world.
That's what my man.
I lost you for a second.
Say what? That's what my manager be. He be in the stocks and the crypto. He probably sit on it now. Yeah.
Oh, Michael's into that. That's dope.
Yeah.
And so yeah, like you said, it was so much power in one place. It was almost like, how is this real? Like, it was just any room you went into has somebody doing something or pulling you into something. And it was positivity, though. I think that was the key, is that everybody who was there was trying to grow. You start to see
they respect you for who you are on there, too. Like, for real, bro. They respect you for who you are on there. You are who you say you are, bro. You'll be straight.
That part. Yeah, because, I mean, where else? Sorry. Go ahead. I was going to say, where else could we... Like we have Instagram followers, but where else can we talk to them?
Yeah, that's that part. Yeah. You know, they got the little Twitter space thing going on too, but that ain't really nothing. That's crazy. You know what I'm saying? So it ain't nothing like Clubhouse for business. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
When it comes to business, everybody on there got some business about themselves. Of course, you can get in some rooms that's toxic, but when you hop in a room that's about business, there you go. It's almost like being in a room with people and you paid $200 to get in this room. You know what I'm saying? A whole showcase with a speaker. You get what I'm saying? And you paid a lot of money to get this information. You sit in there, have a whole conversation with them or ask your question or whatever. Meet tons of people who could probably help you out. Because I know I met plenty of people who can help me.
Right.
I'm a living testimony. It helped. You know what I'm saying?
Right. We're going to be on the Clubhouse website. No, but it was literally, like you said, it was an era. We just hit it at the right time where it was just monstrous business. And that's the network that I understood network at that point. I was like, oh, this is why you have to surround yourself with people like this. It was so crazy, the stuff that was coming out of there. And I want to leave off on one last PowerPoint, though, about how to level up as a producer. Maybe thinking about, we did mindset. What about systems or things you do in your process to kind of save time? Maybe you export your melodies and save them for, like, you know, if you go into a session and you just play loops as opposed to beats. What are some some workflow type stuff?
Okay, like you said, you basically asking me what can you do to keep going when you get beat block or something.
Basically, like how to save time, because time is our biggest asset. And I know for sure there's somebody in this chat that sits there in front of their computer for 2 hours just going through sounds, wasting time.
Oh,
just that. 2 hours. Yeah.
Okay. Well, yeah, your sound selection is big. So, you know, selecting sounds comes with time. It ain't really nothing to do with that. So if you're an upcoming producer, I recommend you do take you a good little bit of time. You know what I'm saying? It could be 2 days, a legit 48 hours. You get what I'm saying? So it could be five. Yeah, like it could be legit, like not back to back, but let's say you got to you gotta do everything you gotta do, it's gonna take you 2 days to get to go through and get your sound together. You know what I'm saying? Like, or you know what you want to sound. You know what I'm saying? Busy. So, I mean, don't go here if you want. You know what I'm saying? Like, basically, like, I'm trying to figure out like how to put it, bro.
Can I ask you a question in between?
Organize your stuff. You know what I'm saying? The best you can. Make favorites if you can. Yeah, come back to beats if you can. If it's not working out, go right back to it. I mean, pull something else up, man. Like, if you don't like it, don't try to make yourself like it. Just go to the next thing. You know what I'm saying? Give yourself a break. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, you when it comes to time, bro, you're gonna have to put a lot aside. Right. There's no way around. No way.
You said two key things. You said one was if you don't like it, don't spend time on it. That's key because I know from making thousands of videos, if the beat that I start off isn't where I needed to be in like 5 to 10 minutes, it's not going to sound good. Like I could spend 2 hours on it. It's not going to sound good. If you have a good good idea, it sounds good from the beginning. It's just a matter of like cleaning it up or moving it around. So you're right about that. That's huge. That's going to save a lot of time. And the other one you said was create favorites. So that's what people don't do. They just go to their kit and they like muscle memorize the kits. But what if they never save those sounds into their own folder? Or just have like an idea of, you know, where it is. Do you save stuff into a different folder or you just know where your stuff is?
I literally know where everything is. Like I know what I want to use. You get what I'm saying? Like, if it's synth, I go to synth. Like I pad, I go to pads. Like I kind of know how I want to put it together now because of how long I've been. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So I know this gonna sound good with this, and this gonna sound good with this, and this gonna sound good with this. I know that this need to go under this. This don't. I don't know my sound selection as far as that. Like I don't know. Shit. Go to get some kits from Busy Works. You know what I'm saying? That's what I say.
Oh, thank you.
If you watch Busy Works beat video, then you know you'll be good. You can make sounds, but at the end of the day, guess what you gotta do? You gotta take time out to learn that. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, go watch Busy Works beat videos. You know what I'm saying? Grab you some cheat codes off of like Producer Grind or something like that. You know what I'm saying? Because it is cheat codes out here, and I'm not gonna say it's not wrong to use. I don't use them rarely, but I want to start. You feel me? Because I noticed that everybody getting a sample. You know what I'm saying? Everybody chopping stuff like, bro, it's literally all the hits samples. You know what I'm saying? Like all the hits got 4 people on it, 2 people on it, three producers on it. You know what I'm saying? So,
right. Yeah. The loop culture, that's a good topic. That's an ending question. But even you're telling me, so for example, with the cheat codes, even Rodney Jerkins, he produced for Michael Jackson and like Britney Spears and all these top worldly acts. And even he uses our chord code system. He was like 03710 without boring you to tears. Basically, it's a minor 7 chord. And he shared that he really liked the chord code system. I'm like, even Rodney Jerkins, who produces for the world's greatest on the planet, uses this stuff. So like that's how much of a cheat code it is. And you mentioned there was something about plugins you said in there. What are your here's what I was gonna say. In plugins, we can't save them like drums to a folder. So like what are your you know, I know you have to give up the sauce, but what is
No, I give it up, bro. That's one thing about me is I'm not really hot no sauce at all because I'm me. So no, you can't sound like me. Mimic it, like I was saying, like I'm me. So I tell you what I use. I tell you what drums I use. I tell you what plugins I go to when I get on my computer. Like I'm not that type of producer. I show my screen. You know what I'm saying? That it ain't no loop. Whatever. You know what I'm saying? Like that's not the case. But don't ever think that, bro. Like, and I don't want no other producer that everybody ain't the same. I just ain't put myself out there. I don't want to put myself out there at all. As like, no, I don't want to like nothing. I would rather put myself out there as, yeah, I'll show you, but you still have to do what you got to do. Because I done got sound kits from top producers course. And this is, if I give it to somebody who up and coming, they're not gonna make the same thing that we're gonna make.
Right.
You get what I'm saying? So like, it, yeah, bro, like I don't mind sharing my sauce, bro. Like I give it up. Like, but you wanna know what plugins I go to when I get on my FL Studio?
Sure. And do you stream too?
No, okay. I don't stream at all.
Oh, okay. Yeah, plugins. Maybe top three plugins that you think are good for sound selection. Oh, I think it froze. Can you hear me? Chat, can you guys hear me? Somebody give me a yes. Need your participation. Busy, always smiling. Oh, Michael says he's okay, good. Darn, we must have lost right at the time marker too. I was trying to get it before 4:30. That was the time marker for today. Darn, well, I guess you got to follow him to figure out his secrets to his sound selection. That's what it comes down to. And what I'll do is I'll DM him on Instagram, and then I'll give you guys a direct line, or Michael, whomever is the contact person, to send in loops so that y'all can collab and do stuff. Because I'm sure he needs more melodies. Who doesn't need more melodies? Click here to follow Hood Beats. All right. So I'm going to give him 2 minutes, but I should keep going on with life. We're already kind of like a half hour delay because of me, and that's my fault. So yes, so that's what I'm gonna do. He left us off on a cliffhanger. So what I'm gonna do is, oh, here he is. Never mind. Oh, there you go. That was suspenseful. Can you hear?
Yeah, I can hear you.
I was saying that he left us guessing.
I had a text message. I don't know what happened.
It's all good. Yeah, just real quick so we can wrap it up because I gotta get rolling soon enough. Is three top plugins used for sound design, and I was telling them that I'm gonna ask your permission. Do you have like a contact or something? Because we have a Discord of 19,000 producers, and I was saying how I'm sure you need melodies to work.
Oh, yeah. I got two emails actually.
Okay, wait, don't tell me here because people. Oh, actually, say it. You can say it. Never mind. I'm restricting your reach.
Go ahead. I got two contact emails. I'm about to make sure. I just made an email for.
Oh, yes.
If
it's a Gmail, it's going to be so many submissions that it could possibly, Gmail's going to be like, you're getting too many emails. What's going on here? That's happening. No, people think I'm joking. Yeah, that's happened before.
Extending my loop email, extending trash back at gmail.com.
Okay, so the audio's chopping, sending trash back?
At gmail.com. Sending just trash. Like that.
Okay. Wait, all right,
yeah.
So sending trash back.
gmail.com. Right. Email me right now, bro.
Yeah. It's a funny email though. Okay.
Yeah. And that's just, you know what I'm saying? And I'm gonna be honest with you. I ain't no disrespectful producer or anything, but that just was to, I'm gonna tell you like this. I wanna work with producers who are confident about their work. So when you see that email, you say, oh, I don't know if Hood gonna work with me. Then you not confident about enough about your work. Oh, mine's ain't trash. I'm sending mine. I'm gonna pull them up. That's what it's about. So I want to put that out. You get what I'm saying? It's a confidence thing. I want confident producers to send me work. Not a producer who was afraid of his work. I'm not gonna send it. Like, no, you can see, you can talk to me. You can know that I will talk. You know what I'm saying? I'll rock with you. I'm genuine. You know what I'm saying? I'm not gonna disrespect you. I'm not gonna go hard on you or anything like that. But that's just the weed out producer. I want confident producers. I want good work. What was the way for me to get? I got a lot of. I post my booking email on there on my Instagram, and I get loops all the time. And I don't think they confident producers. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So I really want confident producers. You know what I'm saying? I feel like that email is what's going
to be. Oh, okay. Because I'm thinking that you were going to send them trash back. Like, you're going to use their loop and then send the trash. That's how I saw it. But you're saying...
If it's trash, I'm going to send it back.
I got you. That makes more sense. Okay, I got you. Okay.
Don't send me nothing fast. Be confident in your work. I know if the email come in there, they confident with their work. They know they ain't sending no trash. They know it ain't gonna come back. So I'm gonna pull it up. You know what I'm saying? And if I use it, it's gonna be used the right way. There's gonna be work, paperwork involved. Straight. Everybody gonna get their percentage points to how everything's supposed to go. Right. You know
what I'm saying? Awesome.
So I do use it, lose. I do reach out, back out. Use it. I'll send you the beat back. I'll let you get your. You can lease it. You can do whatever you need to do. You know what I'm saying? Like I'm moving a little bit different as a producer. You know what I'm saying? I care. So yeah, if I make beats with you, you can do what you gotta do.
See, it was a little choppy, but basically I'll summarize what you said because that's how I think too. Is if me and you collab, I'm gonna let you use that product to make money through the leases, and yeah, I can make money through leases on my end. But if we get a major placement together, we'll split up the points like that.
Everything, we'll split everything up and do it the right way. You know what I'm saying? My management don't really let me do nothing without no paperwork, anyways. Anything major, you know what I'm saying? Like they own me with about lawyers, you know what I'm saying? And all that. I gotta do everything the right way, especially with, like I said, bro, with my music. I wanted to be of confidence, true confidence. You know what I'm saying? But I do have another email. But I would rather just send, you know what I'm saying, trash back.
I like that. Yeah, I'm going to use that in the Discord and tell everybody. And then plug your Instagram too so they could follow up and understand how to follow you over time.
Looking for hoodbeats at gmail.com. That's one. You know, trash back.
Boom.
That's one that I'm using. Yeah.
Good man. I'm getting my studio configured, so we got to wrap that up before it gets too late. Yeah. Because he's on paid time right now. And I just appreciate you. This is a dope conversation. You gave us a lot of gems.
I appreciate you too, busy man. And you know what I'm saying? We're gonna get a lot of work in, man. And you know what I'm saying? One thing real quick, I wanna let a lot of producers know, you know what I'm saying, if artists watching, that you know what I'm saying, I got a big studio downtown Atlanta called Hot Out Studios. It's beautiful, you know what I'm saying? Placement list is huge, it's the future, you know what I'm saying? I work with Big Bang, Playboy Cardi, Engineer Fritz. You know what I'm saying? Wookie, a lot of big, you know what I'm saying, artists close. Like not no extra. So if you're a producer, let's go up. Let's go crazy. Shout out to me. And I appreciate you, busy man, for bringing me on and giving me a voice, bro. Because
Clubhouse fan.
I appreciate that.
Clubhouse fan.
Yes, sir. You put me down, bro. You gave me a voice.
We stick together. All right, I'll catch you and I'll share it to the Discord too.
Yes, sir.
Boom. Peace out, buddy. And Michael, thank you, Michael. All right, so Hood Beats, I know we're patching his audio together a little bit. But long story short, if you guys want to follow him, his Instagram is instagram.com/hoodbeats. And again, he said Future, Playboy Cardi. He even put up the there right there is the picture. I can't see everything on the screen. But I'm assuming he puts posts as placements too. I don't know. I have to check his Instagram. But Future, it says it right here. Future, Waka Flocka, Young Dro, and I think he said Playboy Cardi. I might have heard him wrong though. So that's who this is. And I'm going to also put this announcement in Discord just so you have all the information in one place. And what was there? Something else I wanted to tell y'all. Send them loops. I sent the email. I put the email in the chat. I'll do it one more time. But join the Discord for other placement opportunities as well. Click, say his email. All right, so thank you for hanging in there with me. Again, we got a project that we're working on that I got to wrap up, so I got to go, guys. I appreciate